Hello and welcome to this video. Today I will be showing you how to make a standalone Arduino Uno on a breadboard. So here is a picture of Arduino Uno. And now we want to make this in a breadboard. We don't want to use this module. Rather than using this module, you can use the microcontroller without using the module as well. So let's see how we can do that. So for doing that, we need, obviously, first of all, the microcontroller itself, the ATmega328B. Then we need a crystal oscillator of 16 megahertz, 22 picofarad capacitors, two of these. Then to demonstrate the LED blink program, we need one LED and a current limiting resistor. I'm using 220 ohms resistor here. Then we need one nanofarad capacitor to connect to the RTS pin of this FTDI chip. We need a pull-up resistance. You can use 10K. Then we need some jumper wires. And for programmer, I will be using this FTDI USB to serial converter. There are many other serial converters available. You can use any one. Method is almost same for all the programmers. So for this demonstration, I will be using this FTDI. The reason being that the driver of this FTDI is very easy to find and it's quite easy for beginners to use. So now let's jump into the pin configuration of this microcontroller. So if I go to the data sheet here, we need to see the pin configurations of this chip. So pin configuration is in chapter 5, pin configuration, page number 14. So here we can see the chip itself is shown, 28-pin dual inline package pins are shown. So here you can see the saffron color is the power. Okay. So here the saffron color pins are this AVCC pin number 20. And then we have pin number 7, VCC. So these are the two 5-volt pins. Then obviously the ground pins, we have this black color. So the ground is pin number 22 and pin number 8. Then the reset pin. So reset pin is this pin 1 of this chip. This is the reset pin. And to connect the crystal oscillator, we need this pin number 9 and pin number 10. To demonstrate the LED blink program, we need the pin 13 or digital pin 13 of the Arduino Uno. So the digital pin 13 of Arduino Uno is the pin 19 of this ATmega328B chip. So this is the pin 19 that we are going to connect the LED. So in details, if I show the pin configuration or the pin mapping, rather I would say pin mapping for this ATmega328P with the Arduino. So here I am showing you the pin mapping. You can see the first pin is the reset pin, pin 1, then 7 and 8 VCC ground, 9 and 10 crystal, connecting the crystal, and these digital pins and analog pins are written beside the pin names. You can use this for your reference. Now, how we are going to connect it to the FTDI chip and program? For that, I am going to show you the circuit diagram here. So this is the ATmega328B chip connected to FTDI serial to USB to serial converter. So let's make this connections on our breadboard. So here we have all the equipments that we need, we have here. So let's make the connections and then I will come back. Now that I have made all the connections properly, I have connected the LED pin to pin 13, digital pin 13 of Arduino, and in this chip the pin 19. Then 20 is connected to VCC, 22 is connected to ground. And here pin 1, we have one 10K resistor between the 5 volt and pin 1. We have a 1 nanofarad capacitor or 100 nanofarad capacitor also you can connect between the DTR pin of this FTDI and the pin 1. Between DTR and FTDI, DTR pin of FTDI and pin 1, that is a reset pin, we have a 100 nanofarad capacitor. So here you can see all the connections I have made. I have powered it from the FTDI chip as well. And the RX pin of this FTDI will go to the TX pin of this chip, and the TX pin of FTDI will go to RX pin of this microcontroller. So that is a thing that you have to remember. It will be like TX to RX and RX to TX. So in this way, the connections will be made. Now, so that's the part of the hardware. Now let us jump into the software part of this. So now if I go to the Arduino IDE here, we need to write a program, or you can use the examples, the default examples program as well. So rather than using that examples program, let's write a program on our own. So the first step is to define the pins. So first step is pin mount. So that we have defined the first pin as a output, that is pin 13, the LED pin 13 as a output. And now let's write a program. We are turning on this pin 13 high, and then let's put a delay of 1 second or 1000 millisecond. And then again, after turning off the LED, then again, delay of, let's say 1000 millisecond. So that's the simplest program for testing this Arduino. Now let's compile this. Okay, let's keep it the default name and let's compile it. So now done compiling, we have to connect the FTDI with the USB mini cable. So if I connect this with the USB mini cable here, you can see I will be connecting it. So once I connect it, so now this pin 13 is already blinking. You can see that is because the chip is already loaded with the Arduino bootloader. If you don't have the chip with Arduino bootloader, then this trick will not work. So that is one thing that I forgot to mention earlier, that you need to have a bootloaded Arduino bootloaded 80Mega 328V chip to work with this serial programming. Now, if you don't have such a chip which don't have the Arduino bootloader, then I will make a separate video for that, how to burn bootloader into the chip. That's not a difficult, that is again very easy process. So I will show you in that in a different video. For now, I have the Arduino bootloader installed into the chip, and we want to program that program that we have created just now into this chip. So first step is to select the serial port, that is COM3. It is by default, it is already selected because I have already installed the FTDI earlier. So once I install it, it will be automatically select the chip. So next is to click on upload button. So if I click on upload here, now you can see the red LED is blinking, and now it is already uploaded. And you can see the green LED that started blinking at a delay of 1 second. So that is how the simple it is to make a Arduino Uno of your own. So if you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the like button if it is helpful for you. If you want to support, then there is a link in the description. You can support this channel as well. So thank you for watching.